So there is a big event coming up on this weekend in honor of a great hero, who was killed in Iraq serving our country in 2005. His name, Lieutenant Dennis Zilinski II. And there's a memorial fund on his behalf. And I wanted to introduce you today to his mom, who runs this organization, raises money for an important cause. The website is runwithdennis.org. They have an event coming up this weekend on the 13th. And Marion joins me now. Marion, good morning. How are you?
Good morning, Bill. I'm fine. So thank you for having me.
Well, first, tell me about your son.
Great kid. He graduated from Christian Brothers Academy, went on to the Military Academy, also known as West Point.
Wow.
When he graduated there, he went on to Ranger School. He is a U.S. Army Ranger. And he took control of a platoon in the infantry part of the 187, which is the 101st Airborne. He is a Rokasan. And he took control of that unit and was deployed in September of 2005 to Beji, Iraq.
And, I know you have another son as well, Matt, who is deployed as well, right?
Major Matthew Zilinski with the United States Army National Guard.
Oh, God bless him.
He is currently deployed in Kosovo at this time.
Wow.
And we also have 2,000 of our very own New Jersey National Guardsmen deployed.
How is your family doing? I mean, it's been a long time. It's been 14 years, but you are still fighting the fight on behalf of other veterans. Take us back when you think about the sacrifice. And I talk to a lot of people and parents who say, it's almost, Marion, they're discouraging their kids from serving. And you've taken really the total opposite stance. But what was it like? I mean, when you found out you'd lost your son, how did you turn it into a positive?
Well, you have two choices. You can give up on living, or you can go on and live life and make a difference. My son would not approve if my husband Dennis and I just gave up.
Mm-hmm.
That was not who he was. Before he deployed, we were in the car and I asked a stupid mom question, and it was, "Are you afraid?" And he said to me, "I'm afraid of losing one of my soldiers because when I come home, I'll have to face their parents and tell them I failed them." Dennis was killed with the only soldiers out of his unit, so he didn't have to face their parents. And I thought about that, and I realized to keep my son proud of both me and my husband, we decided to participate in this memorial fund to aid and assist our wounded warriors and to offer as much assistance that we can to the troops that are serving overseas.
Wow. What a powerful moment that must have been, and that stays with you. Well, thank you, Marion, for what you're doing. The website is runwithdennis.org. Just quickly, the last few seconds I have, tell me about the event this weekend. It's Friday night is your gala.
It's Friday night, and it is called A Toast to Dennis, A Night of Remembrance, because not only do we remember Dennis, we honor all of our active duty and veterans that are in attendance, and we also remember all those that were killed on 9/11 as well. It's a great event, a sit-down dinner. The band this year is donating their services.
Wow.
And it's the Docks of Rock, and it helps us to earn more monies to help our wounded warriors. Our keynote speaker is David Cross, and we sponsored his leg amputation several years ago.
Wow.
Giving him the opportunity to move forward with his life. And that's the fourth leg amputation that we have sponsored.
Yeah. That is incredible. You're doing incredible work. The money goes
Thank
to an
you.
Incredible cause. I know Brian Thompson from Channel 4 New York is going to be the guest presenter. It's going to be an outstanding event. So people just need to go to runwithdennis.org. Help this incredible cause, whether you can make the gala or not. You can certainly contribute. And you hear this is the kind of activity. I always talk about this, Marion. It's never about awareness. It is always about action. And what you're doing on behalf of veterans and their families and these deployed soldiers is incredible. I have to tell you, I get chills when you tell that story about your son and one of the last conversations that you had before he deployed. So God bless you, Marion. You are doing incredible work.
God bless you as well. And thank you so much for giving us this opportunity to reach out to all of your listeners.
You got it, Marion. We'll certainly stay in touch, and I look forward to helping you next year as well.